Welcome. This is new and old. Today we are working on a 2002 Dodge Neon. This is back when you could get them, relatively inexpensive. My sisters had this thing for close to 8 years. I'm just trying to adjust the camera here. And what we're going to do, as you can see, we're headed for that motor mount. Basically, this has got a wicked vibration to it. And I'm thinking it's that middle motor mount that's what's bad. I have a new one coming in the mail here relatively soon. But, it's hard to say. I'm taking a guess at this. Because I can't physically see it, which is really bad because I can't physically see it. So we're just going to say, I just want to see if it's not going to be that difficult to take off the top motor mount here and take a look and see. This is actually standard. Go figure. To see if we can see what's going on here. What size is this? Oh, is it not going to be a standard size? Of course not. I got 19. I got 17. 17 is too big. 19. So it is an 18. Okay, well, let's go grab another
socket set.
It's 18. So, it's what we're doing. That's not gonna be strong enough. We're gonna have to. One thing about that, this is not that strong. Probably should get a extension, a 3-inch extension. Oh gosh. Okay. That's a compressor. Oh, that one there doesn't look broke. That's good. Going to stick our... Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that. That bolt was tight. That bolt was extremely tight. So let's do this. I don't know if I'm going to have an open end wrench to get to these. I'm not 100% sure. I believe the size of that looks to be like half an inch, maybe. Let's see. Yeah, that's half an inch. It's going to be a fun one to get down there. Oh, that's going to be fun. Under. It's going to be. When you're working with. Okay. They don't seem to be too tight. I wonder if you could take. The problem is you're not going to be able to get. I don't think I can get that out. Let's see if we can get the bottom. Key thing here is going to be the bottom bolts. That's going to be their key. Looks like a maybe on the bottom bolts. Looks like a maybe. Can't tell the size. Can't reach your fingers in there. Can't reach your. I don't know the size of it. I may have to take that off though. Get to this motor mount. Let's see. Yep, I'm gonna have to. Okay. Well, have a good bolt there. Don't know if I'm going to get this bolt. These bolts are going to come out. Yeah. Okay. Let's judge the size. I'm going to say 5/8. I can't get my finger in there. Oh shoot, the 15. Maybe. Years. Hello, this is new and old. Today I'm just continuing wrenching on my sister's car, and this is a thing with Dodge. You know, I've had this problem with these old Neon, and this is with all cars. You wrench on these cars and they leave you no room to get to anything. And basically our goal here is to pull this. We're not going to pull the power steering pump out. I don't think I am quite yet. I'm going to try to get this bolt without losing it. But you know, it's with these cars, always have to mess around with them, and this is the 15 more minutes. Now this is the life that we have to live in for a mechanic, and I'm gonna tear all this stuff apart. I hope this is okay. Steering bolt. And we got another pair of steering bolts. Thank you. Now you have to be able to do this. I don't think this is gonna work. I'm gonna get my little. I don't think this is long enough to do this. Oh, almost. Yeah, I need to get my one inch extension. I will be back. Okay, I'm back. So we gotta take the power steering pump off. This is, and I don't know if you guys can even see. I probably should check that, shouldn't I? Okay, and the bolts about the same. Okay. Now we have to do. Now, if you guys look, I'll see if I can zoom you in. So now this is going to be basically the classic, classic reach around. Get my trusty 15. Nope, not 15. Get my trusty wrenchie. Can get this bolt to come out. Is there anything else hiding? Be 15. I wonder if I can jack that car up anymore. I don't think I can without doing the oil pump. One thing we don't want to do is break the oil filter. Okay. Basically, this bolt here is supposed to come off. Getting to it, it's gonna be fun. I don't think there's anything else in my way. So I get the bolt, get the tensioner. Oh, there's a bolt down there too. Okay. Just they make stuff so damn difficult. I bet you this comes off with the tensioner. That's a 15. Let's see if my son of a see if my 15 socket will get in there. Thank you. don't want to back myself into a hole here. Hello, this is new and old. Well, it's late at night. It's probably about 11 o'clock at night. And finally got the motor mount out. Basically, this is piss poor engineering. There's no excuse to spending 6 hours to get a motor mount out. But, you know, it's what it is. It's what it is. You know, these engineers, you know, they don't think about, you know, what if someone drives their vehicle for 10 years, like my sister has, and you have to replace these parts to keep these vehicles running? Well, so, anyways, I'll give you a quick glance here. This is the motor mount right here, center mode, motor mount. This is what had to come off. This is the main bracket that holds, I say it's the timing belt cover. It also holds a power steering pump. It's also got the tensioner on it. It's also got the tensioner too. So, and that was a bitch. I mean, that was a pain. But hey. And then if you look down here, basically, to get all this stuff out, you have to, well, jack the motor up really high, take off the power steering pump. You have to take off the front bracket, the aluminum cover, which there shows the timing belt. It's basically one of the timing belt covers. And this has had a new timing belt. We paid a mechanic to put one on about 40,000 miles ago. So it's, no, about, yeah, about 40,000 miles ago. So it's got a 100,000 mile belt on it. But so yeah, well, then we took the power steering pump off, had to take that off, because you couldn't get the bracket out unless you took the power steering pump out. So then this one here is a gotcha. This one right here, this is a bracket that goes on the side right here. Make sure you take that out too, because that has to come out in order to get the bracket out. Tomorrow the part's coming in, and I also have the bottom, oh yeah, and you have to take off the bottom motor mount too, because you basically have to level the engine, pivot the engine, you know, you're talking, you know, 5-6 inches up or down to get these bolts out, because otherwise they ain't gonna come out, motor's too close to the fender to get them out. And just be cautious of your AC lines. That is a major concern if you don't want to break an AC line and have to recharge your air conditioner. Replace air conditioning lines, that's costly. Yeah, that's really about it. What's due on this car is the motor mounts needs to be replaced, and then we're also going to do the spark plugs and wires. What else? We're gonna check the rear brakes. That needs to be done. Gas gauge is a little bit funky on this car too. It doesn't go up to full when you fill it, so we may tackle that. I don't know yet. It depends. I don't know. Radiator was replaced on on this car a while back, so don't have to worry about that. That was a fun one too. So yeah, of course, air filter was replaced. Gonna change the oil. I'm just gonna put Penn's oil. Dodge, last time I owned the Dodge Ram too. So and Penn's oil is their recommended oil. Actually, full synthetic for the Dodge Ram. It's like a 520, I think. But for this car here, it's just a normal conventional 530 is what we've always ran in it. So yeah, that's basically it. It's tight. It's very tight. I'm going to show you guys some clips here of what I did. Hopefully the film came out okay. I'm going to try to film a little bit better when I put it back in, so stay tuned for that video. This will be a two-part series, and we'll go from there. So this is new and old with ways of life, and this is a 2002 Dodge Neon. This is back when you could buy a car stripped down model. I'll do a review on this car. It's actually, except for the working on it part, it's actually not a bad car, really. If you wanted a cheap car back in 2002, this is what you bought. So, anyways, this is new and old. You all have a good one. Take care.